Hello, Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer of Matari preaching Christianity. He rendered exposition of Hebrews 10 verses 1 to 14. For the law, having a shadow of good things to come, are the knowledge of our Father God and His Son, the Christ. As the Samaritan woman at the well pointed out to Christ Jesus, that when Christ come, He will tell us everything. So that's the shadow of the good things to come, and not the very image of the things. That is, the rabbis did not tell people of the Christ. Never with those sacrifices which they offered year by year, continually make the comers, that means rabbis, coming one generation after the other unto perfect, but rather more and more corrupt. So there the generation of the rabbi passed. In the past, the rabbi used to be very honest and clean, and as the corruption started coming into the scriptures and the people became more greedy, so they started corrupting the practices also. So the more and more imperfect and corrupt they became. For then would they not have ceased to be offered, because that the worshippers once purged should have had no more conscience of sins. So they were not, you know, they were not properly purged, and the rabbis remember the Jesus said, don't do what they do, but do what they tell you to do. But in those sacrifices there is a remembrance again made of sins every year. So every year they offer the sacrifices to sins. But for it is not possible that the blood of bulls and of goats should take away sins. So that was just ritual, you know, that means this, they were every year they were making these sacrifices for sins. That means the blood of bulls and goats was not good to take away their sins, to clean their hearts of the sins, but they were committing more sins, you know. Wherefore, when He, the Christ Jesus, cometh into the world, He saith, sacrifice and offering thou wouldest not, but a body, a living temple of living God, hast now prepared me for sacrifice. That means sacrifice of the human being, the temple of the God. That is, in Christ Jesus you carry your own cross in burnt offerings and sacrifices for sins. Thou hast had no pleasure, as it does not lead you to perfection, rest or salvation. So that sins every year they were doing, it doesn't lead you to perfection, but just keep on performing. Then said I, the very Christ Jesus, lo, I come. In the volume of the book it is written of me, to do thy will, O God. Jesus came to do the will of our Father, and not His own will, as the temple priests were doing. Now temple priests did their own wills, as the authority on law, whilst Christ Jesus, just the opposite, came to do the will of our Father and not His own will, as the temple priests were doing, and not benefiting from it, as a corrupt temple priest cannot deliver a just judgment. So the temple priest is corrupt, and how can he lead the other people into salvation? Above, when he, Christ Jesus, said, sacrifice and offering and burnt offerings and offerings for sins thou wouldest not, neither hadest pleasure therein, which are offered by the law. Then said he, our brother Christ Jesus, lo, I come to do thy will, O God, our Father. That is, Moses priest for doing the wills of men, the temple priest, who were their master, and they were coining the moral laws, the old wine, but were corrupting them, producing holes in the old cloth of Moses year by year. But our brother Christ Jesus came to do the will of our incorruptible Father God, giving us a perfect sermon in God, our gospel, for perfect salvation or rest. He, Christ Jesus, taketh away the first corruptible covenant in Adam that was taught by his high priest in Moses, the written Torah, or the scriptures, that being passed from generation to generation, were called old cloth, subject to corruption, that he, our brother Christ Jesus, may establish the second incorruptible covenant in God, where we receive instructions through the revelation of his will on individual basis, or his word on individual basis, that cannot be written down in ink on paper, and was known as the oral Torah, or the brand new cloth, untouched by human hands, by the which will we are sanctified through the offering of the body of Christ Jesus, or Jesus the Christ, once for all. You remember what applied to flesh, the opposite to spirit. And every priest in Moses standeth daily, ministering and offering oftentimes the same sacrifices, which can never take away sins, because sins were coming again and again every year. But this man, our brother Christ Jesus, after he had offered one sacrifice for blasphemies and not sins forever, sat down on the right hand of God. Remember, John the Baptist was killed by the sinners, whilst our brother Christ Jesus was killed by the blasphemers. From henceforth, expecting till his enemies be made his footstool, for by one offering he hath perfected for ever them that are sanctified. So in Jesus he came to offer only one sacrifice, whereas the temple rabbis, they were offering sacrifices for the sins of people with the blood of animals, and every year they were doing it, and still that did not lead to any perfection, because if there was perfection, then they did not need to repeat it every year, but they were doing it. But in Christ Jesus, so we cleanse ourselves with the blood of Christ, which is the gospel, and once we clean it, and we attain perfection in Christ Jesus. So it's up to you to let Christ into your heart, or close your heart to blasphemy and cheating and fleecing people. So you need a heart which is childlike, free of blasphemies, no hypocrisies. Just what you are inside should be outside.